Good evening. Would everyone please be seated? Just a quick reminder that if you could keep your cell phones in your pocket during the ceremony. From this beautiful place, we take ourselves out of our usual routine of our daily lives to witness this unique moment between Andrew and Marley. Today, they join their lives together in the union of marriage. To all the guests here, or virtually, they are happy to share this moment with you. They have known most of you for many years. Some of you have watched them grow up, went to school with them, or are now co-workers with them. Because you are the ones who have supported them and know them so well, It is only fitting that you are here to share this once-in-a-lifetime moment with them. Marley and Andrew have known each other for over a decade. Their love began and grew as they learned about each other and themselves. They are the true example of love. Despite everyone's differences, love is the great unifier, our one universal truth. No matter who we are, where we come from, what we believe in, we know this one thing. Love is what we're doing right. That's why you are both standing here today. We have all loved in our lifetimes, and at this moment, we are reminded the ability to love is the very best part of humanity. At this time, Marley and Andrew would like to invite Marley's godmother, Carrie Hoffman, to share a reading.
There we go. Union by Robert Fulham. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes. Indeed, you have been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held, riding in a car, or over a meal, or during long walks, all those sentences that began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. Those late night talks that included someday, somehow, and maybe, all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, excuse me, you know all those things we promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you have learned much from one another in these many years. Now you shall say a few words that take you across the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
As Marley and Andrew have prepared for the ceremony for this part of the celebration, they reflected on what it is they've loved about each other for so long. And I was told this was the easiest part of the planning. So now Marley and Andrew would like to read a message to each other. I don't have it. I thought you were reading the message.
No.
Okay. At this time, Andrew and Marley would like to welcome their friend Sarah Lowe to share a reading.
Wilford Arlen Peterson. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It's never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world, It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing each other, it is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. Mm-hmm. It is finding room for the things of spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. It is discovering what marriage can be at its best.
The bride and groom will now take part in a unity tree planting ceremony to symbolize the roots of their relationship and start of a new beginning as they become each other's families today. Andrew and Marley, today you stand here ready to share the rest of your lives together as a married couple. But long before today, your parents provided you with the foundation of love and support, which has brought you to this point. Andrew and Marley would like to invite their parents to come up and add soil to their unity tree as a symbol of their love, contribution to the foundation of their marriage. They have chosen a tree that will not only grows, but provides fruit that represents their hope for a fruitful marriage. Though like marriage, lemons can be tart at times, love and consideration can make them even sweeter. Each grain of soil represents your time and effort you are going to dedicate to your love and your marriage. This time, we would like to welcome cousin and friend of the family, Chris Hogue, to read a prayer.
God, we ask for your blessings upon this man and woman as we celebrate this momentous occasion in their lives. Grant them happiness and contentment as they establish their new home, create a new family, and explore the depths of their love for one another and for you. Bless their families and friends and relationships, which have supported, strengthened, and sustained them throughout their lives. Bless their home as a place of love and of peace. And if times grow hard, tempers grow short, help them to look into their hearts and remember the love that brought them here today. Amen.
We now come to the words in the ceremony that Andrew and Marley have been waiting to hear the most, the words that they will be promising to each other. Andrew, please repeat after me. Marley, I'm proud to take you as my wife.
Marley, I'm proud to take you as my wife.
I promise to be your most loyal and true friend.
I promise to be your most loyal and true friend.
I promise to communicate fully and fearlessly and to value our differences as much as our common ground.
I promise to communicate fully and fearlessly to value our differences as much as our common ground.
I promise from this day forward, you will never walk alone.
I promise to this day forward, you'll never walk alone.
You will never have to bear any burden without me beside you.
You'll never have to bear any burden without me beside you.
I promise to share your laughter as well as your tears.
I promise to share your laughter as well as your tears.
You are my greatest joy.
You are my greatest joy.
And our love is most amazing adventure.
And our love is the most amazing adventure.
I promise to always encourage you in life and be your biggest fan.
I promise to always encourage you in life and be your biggest fan.
I will make an effort every day to be a better person for you.
I will make an effort to be a better person for you, bigger person.
I promise to love you, respect you, and support you, no matter any uncertainties.
I promise to love you, respect you, support you, no matter uncertainties.
Marley, do you accept these vows and enter into a loving union with Andrew?
I do.
Marley, please repeat after me. Andrew, I'm proud to take you as my husband.
Andrew, I'm proud to take you as my husband.
I promise to be your loyal and best friend.
I promise to be your loyal and best friend.
I promise to communicate fully and fearlessly and to value our differences as much as our common ground. I promise from this day forward, you will never walk alone.
I promise from this day forward, you will never walk alone.
You will never have to bear any burden without me beside you.
You'll never have to bear any burden without me beside you.
I promise to share your laughter as well as your tears.
I promise to share your laughter as well as your tears.
You are my greatest joy, and our love is our most amazing adventure.
You're my greatest joy, and our love is our most amazing adventure.
I promise to always encourage you in life and be your biggest fan.
I promise to always encourage you in life and be your biggest fan.
I will make an effort every day to be a better person for you.
I'll make an effort every day to be a better person for you.
I promise to love you, respect you, and support you, no matter the uncertainties of the future that is presented.
I promise to love you, support you, and respect you, no matter the uncertainties of the future that are presented.
Andrew, do you accept these vows and enter into a loving union with Marley?
I do.
It's time for the rings. Your wedding rings are the outward and visible sign of the inward and invisible bond which already unites your two hearts in love. Your wedding rings are a symbol of your promises to one another. The ring is unbroken, never ending. It is a symbol of committed, unending love. Andrew, please place the ring on Marley's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
It is a symbol of our eternal love.
Is it a symbol? It is a symbol of our eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And a promise of all my tomorrows.
Marley, please place the ring on Andrew's finger. With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
Marley and Andrew, I offer you all the good wishes to you on this very special day. May your life together be filled with prosperity, laughter, and love. May you always share open and honest communications between each other. May all the years come be filled with moments to celebrate and renew your love. May your love be a lifelong source of excitement, contentment, respect, and devotion for one another. May the adventures you take together guide your love. Life has taught you love does not exist at a gaze, but as you both look in the same direction. And so now, by the power vested in me at the love of this wedding, it is my honor to declare Mr. and Mrs. Andrew and Marley Langendorfer. You may seal this declaration with a kiss.
Thank you. like.
Thank you.
I guess they have a band playing. I'm sorry.
Items. Also, in about 15 minutes, there will be more entertainment provided by what I've done with the family band. So, we're going to check that out in about 15 minutes.
have anything else in the record?
I thought we already did.
You are recording?
Years, it's about time.
It's about time, okay. Thank you very much, we appreciate it.
One thing, so walk down and all these robots.
I've got ladies and gentlemen right here. Can you just wave at the camera for me? That'd be great. Wave at the camera. Say hello to the bride and groom. What do you think you want to say to the bride and groom?
Good, how are you?
Do me a favor and just wave at the camera to all of the folks out here in Facebook land. Let us know. I should say Facebook, it works on YouTube today. So, some words of wisdom to the bride and groom. And I'm going to back up just a little bit. Get everybody in. Any words of wisdom?
Never go to bed angry. Always give each other a kiss goodnight and goodbye.
There you go.
Always say yes.
Yep.
Learn the words, yes,
ma'am. Even better saying that.
To the groom. Again, say that again there, gentlemen in the middle.
Learn the words, yes, ma'am.
There you go. I like it. Very, very good. I appreciate that. Thanks so much.
You're welcome.
Bye, hearing aid.
Bye.
Yeah.